Hi guys, welcome back. So, Luckin Coffee, guys, it is seriously breaking out, as I kept saying for the last few days. It finally doesn't disappoint us. During the last couple of days, I said that Luckin was doing something interesting. First quietly climbing up, and then V-shaped recovery during these days, and strong breakout finally. It had went up 23% just for the last 3 days. Now, every day it's not too much, but slowly, steadily breaking out. Now, the next target is 11. Now, I'm not here to tell you to buy right now, and I hope no one asks me whether it's still okay to buy a Luckin since it's run up, because I have learned my lesson. The first time I introduced Luckin to you guys was in January. This day, it was 9. After I said it, and some people bought in after, it ran up to as high as 15. Everyone was very happy. But then one day, it crashed because of the bankruptcy news. Actually, chapter 15, not entirely bankruptcy. But it was enough to scare a lot of people away, and I got blamed a lot, and I felt really bad. So this time, I'm not going to recommend anyone to buy after the run-up, because I have said it the whole time when it was steadily climbing every day. I said it was going to break out soon. And I also said in one of my videos that if the Chinese government wants to grow their financial market, then there is one stock that is very important for them, which is Luckin Coffee. Because if Luckin is good, then it can gain back more trust from international investors. Right now, every time the US government would use the example of Luckin Coffee to accuse Chinese companies to commit fraud, to be not trustworthy, and also the short sellers like Wolfpack Research or Muddy Water would just keep shorting the Chinese stocks, coming up with short reports that refer to Luckin Coffee. So that is why I always think that if they want to grow their financial market, then Luckin has to be good. It has to turn people's image on Chinese companies from negative to positive. And the only way to do that first is to solve the issue of this Luckin Coffee incident. And the solution is for Luckin to have good operation day to day, improve their revenue, improve their profit margin, improve their business, and result in the share price. As long as we have growth of the company and the share price, I believe a lot of people would need to shut up on the Luckin Coffee fraud issue in the future. And also, there was this news before. Some people took it as bad news because it says American stock investors can file the lawsuit for Luckin Coffee in Shanghai. So the court in China said that they can take this file case. And if that goes through, this would be the first case for all Chinese stocks to accept international lawsuits about Chinese companies in China. Right now, there are 3 investors filing this lawsuit, and potential ones would be 20, and also there are many others that have inquired before. When this news came out, a lot of people thought it's a bad news, but I actually think it may not be entirely bad. I actually took it as a good news because it means that they want to clear out the damage created by the fraud issue before, and they want to start to do things right. And this way, it would help international investors to slowly gain more trust back for Chinese companies. And it's not just Luckin Coffee, it's for all Chinese companies listed in foreign exchange, especially because they always felt that there is no insurance, no security. It's a foreign company, and especially it's foreign companies in China, which the Chinese government would protect, and there's no way to sue them or do anything about it because they're under the protection from the Chinese government. But now, this is a turning point because it's the Chinese government that's okay, you guys are allowed to sue our companies in China because we want to do things right. So I think it's a good sign for Luckin Coffee. It shows how important it is for them to make things right for the international investors, and it would be good news not just for Luckin Coffee, but also for the other Chinese companies as well. So that's why I actually took it as a good news and got more bullish on Luckin because of that. Because it really confirms my point of view before as of how important Luckin is politically and economically for other Chinese companies listed in foreign exchange. And also the reason why I said I wanted to buy more if it dips, even though I have a big position, was because I think there would be more catalysts coming up. Besides the fact that I said yesterday that summer, it's coming up, economy is coming up, and it would be good for the retail sector. And also this year's stock market kind of favors consumer or retail, but there is something else, some other catalyst. And it is the IPO for the other franchise brand for drinks like Nai Xue and Hey Tea. They are going to have their IPO in the Hong Kong market. Also famous brands in China for drinks, bubble tea, especially among the youth, the millennials, similar demographic as Luckin Coffee, but different products because Luckin focus more on coffee, of course, but they're all in the same sector, right? And they should roughly have similar numbers of stores in the country with similar demographic and similar price range. Maybe Luckin would be a bit cheaper because it always have a lot of coupon. No, I don't see their actual valuation for the IPO for Nai Xue and Hey Tea, but I really assume or expect them to be much, much higher valuation than Luckin Coffee right now. And in comparison, it would make Luckin really, really cheap and undervalued. So I think this might be a good catalyst. So congratulations for all the long-term investors for Luckin Coffee. Good job holding it through such a roller coaster, so much storm. I think we are starting to see light soon. Now, after the breakout, there is usually backtest. I don't know when exactly, either pullback or consolidation. But the overall trend should be heading north. Right now, the next target would be 11, and I won't be surprised if it gets back to like the range of 15 to 20 by the summer. If all of the catalysts I said comes up and Luckin can report a good earning, which I expect it would, given the fact that many stores are already in positive margin and the sales were running really not bad even during the pandemic. But don't take my words and don't try to use it to time the stock, because it's many times that Luckin or LKCO, they are very volatile stock and full of uncertainties, and whenever there is a black swan news, you know what happened. Could be it's down 60-50% in one day. Not everyone can take this, especially if you have high blood pressure. Stay away from this. But for all the diamond hands for Luckin Coffee, again, congrats for holding strong, and we now should sit tight and show on. Hopefully. Last time I got so much blame for introducing Luckin and I felt really bad after the fall. So now that it's back to above 9, I feel more ease now. And the thing is, right now it's still traded in the OTC market, so the volume usually remains small because many people still cannot trade it. So wait until we can be relisted one day in a major stock exchange, then would be the real show on. Right now is the appetizer. I still have high hope for this. Now that Luckin Coffee has broken out, is the next one LKCO to break out? I really hope so. As I said yesterday, it has broken out of this long consolidation of the triangle. Right now it's backtesting, it seems like. So hoping this one would be the next one to break out. Now if it falls back down to this trend line, it means it's a false breakout, so it might come back to backtest the support around 120 to 130 if it's a false breakout. Now I have a few comments asking me about what I think of LKCO partnership with Microsoft. Well, for now we need official confirmation. This is what I find back in January though. The CEO of Imago, Mr. Liu, said that with the further development of autonomous driving, both Imago and Luckin are solely dedicated to leveraging our combined spatial, temporal, and HD map capabilities to improve our value proposition to manufacturers and consumers. Here it says, Imago has become an important partner of Microsoft MCVP, which is the Microsoft Connected Vehicle Platform. So right now, they are recognized as a major participant and a technology leader in the construction of smart highways across China and vehicle to everything technology. We believe these infrastructure changes represent massive adoption of autonomous driving throughout China and feel that we are positioned well. So this is the article back in January. So since then, Imago already had established partnership with Microsoft, which is not much a surprise for us because we know that Imago is really one of the five key players for HDMap that have the certificate to be allowed to do this. So a lot of the international companies would have to work with them. I said before, Imago is quite strategic for a lot of foreign brands because not only they have the technology, but also they don't have the conflict of interest like the other HDMap providers. And that would give them a good advantage to begin with. So I said before that I see cooperations with big companies, big names, to be more and more in the future. And I also said that I think there were more partnerships with the companies that we don't know or we cannot know because there might be some non-disclosure agreement. Because it really depends on the client. Some clients, they don't want to share who they work with for the service providers, so we wouldn't know. But I know they also work with Tencent for some big projects for the cities. And last time during my interview with the management back in March, they told me that before they were not very much attentive to the investor relationship or the PR. So from now on, they would be putting more efforts into press release, announcing their progress, etc., to build relationship with the investors. So I think it's gonna be more and more news from the company in the future. And for now, my Discord member shared with me that Luo Kang just opened a Twitter account, so that is a good start, good sign. It means they really want to start making more announcements, engaging with investors. So that is of course good for us investors, for LKCO, to know more about the company more in time. And it seems like they do expect more good news from the company to come out later. For them to open a Twitter account at this moment. For now, I've covered LKCO and Luckin Coffee. Now, let's go over the market and our trades. Now, just a side note. If I have not covered your stock in my video, it's because right now I'm still following the list voted on the Discord. I've covered NIO, EH, and LKCO, and Luckin Coffee. And it seems like the next one with the highest vote is Palantir and Zepp. I would be getting on working on that. Now, recently, the index had been doing mostly consolidating on the side, moving very slowly. Not much happening. I think it's waiting for the CPI number to be released tomorrow morning. So if it's good or maybe just not worse than last time, it should be still okay. But if it's even worse than expectation, then it would be quite volatile. As we should still remember, it was this day when the CPI reported to be the highest of the past 11 years. So it created a lot of volatility in the market, big sell-off. But this time, I think people kind of expected to be volatile already. So I think it had digested some selling pressure, especially in the afternoon. We see that since 1 o'clock in the afternoon, it started to dive quickly. I think it started to digest some bad news, the smart money. But this morning, it opened up quite high, it went up to as high as 14,000. We haven't seen 14,000 for a while. It was positive 0.5% and then came down all the way to minus 0.09%, wipe out all the growth for the day, trapping some people inside. And it's the same thing recently. When it goes up, the volume shrink. When it goes down, the volume spike. So selling pressure is more than the upward pressure. But it seems like when the market goes on the side doing consolidation like this, then it provides a good atmosphere for the small growth stocks, especially the memes. because the FANG stocks were putting off for a while. A lot of news about the lawsuits in other countries and also the tax increase would be mainly targeting the mega caps, the FANG stocks. That's why they have been off fire for a while in the past few weeks. And during this time of the FANG stock consolidation, it was the small caps running up because the money were moving from the mega cap to small growth stocks. But friendly reminder again, this is not always like this. It's quite rare for so many meme stocks to be flying on every day. I've reminded many times to not FOMO, don't suggest to chase. And especially if you want to play with the meme stocks, you need to control the position and you need to know when to stop. At some point, take some profit instead of putting more money into it. Otherwise, you might earn money at first and then end up losing more back in the game. As we don't know when the music will stop and you don't want to be caught at the end to be the last one holding the bag. And also, I insist the money moving very fast. It's very hard to time. So when you play with these stocks, don't be greedy. Know when to take profit. As we see recently, these 2 days, it had been moving out of the AMC and GameStop was still okay today, but after hour, it decreased 6%, at most 13% because of the share offering again. But something to remind you is now that Bitcoin had gained back some momentum with a nice rebound these 2 days, the speculative money might be moving out of stocks to get back to the crypto. The money who moved out of crypto before went into mostly, I think, speculative place. For example, the Wall Street Bets or a lot of the penny stocks, the small caps, growth stocks. And if Bitcoin continue rebounding, more money from speculative play would get into the crypto again. Just a friendly reminder, okay? Speaking of meme stocks, a few days ago, I recommended TKAT for trade. I said it's potentially a meme stock because I think the NFT concept stocks is not over yet. Even after the volatility of the market, it stay flat, holding steady. So I said, I think there's still chance for this one. And today it went up 19% at closing. At some point, suddenly it jumped as high as 31% to $24. This is crazy. So maybe NFT is again back. If you had held through the whole time since last Thursday, then congratulations. And if you didn't and you want to enter, there is a support at 20.7, not a strong support, and another stronger support at 19.3. I usually like to buy a stock before the run up and wait for the pop, but if you want to chase, you can try with the support I just mentioned and have fun. But this is mainly for entertainment, okay? A little bit side bet casino, because I think a lot of people have been locked down for too long and haven't been to the casino for too long. So this is how the meme stocks become so important, right? So if you want to try it out, use a small position that's insignificant to your portfolio, like 1%. So if you set the stop loss of 10%, then you are just at most losing 0.1% or 0.2%. EH, last night I said I don't recommend to chase at this point because I think it might go up to 43 and then come back down to the range of maybe 35 to 36. And today it did went up to 42.59 and then came back down to 37. Yesterday I saw a comment saying last week I said not to chase. Well, last week I said that see if there is bad news for Chinese stocks, like the listing or financial reports, to drive the dip down. And if it doesn't break the support, it's a good buying opportunity. And I said the support had become 27. So on this day, there was the bad news of blacklisting more companies from the US and it dipped exactly to 27. And last Friday, I said during my weekend video about Yihang, I said it's still heading up. It can still grow. On this day, I said the institutions had done this and this for 2 days to try to make people sell. So I don't think they are gonna give up at this point, so I think it would continue going up. So if you did not watch my videos before, you can watch it throughout the last 2 weeks whenever I mention about EH, okay? So I never said during this range to not chase for EH because I didn't think it was chasing. I actually thought it was the beginning. And during this big dip and consolidation, you know I have been buying the dip, and every time I did, I share it on the Discord too. So please don't blame me for missing out on this. You had all the chance to buy EH during this time, and also right now, if you sold out of the position, if you didn't believe in Yihang 1 month ago, and now you want to buy back in because it has run up, then maybe your conviction on the company is not as strong. So whenever there is a big dip or watch sell, you might end up cutting loss again. And I don't want anyone to lose on Yihang again, unless you are really long-term investor with strong conviction on this. Because right now we still have a lot of uncertainties on this company, as I have addressed before. So it's not for anyone who doesn't have enough conviction on this company. Okay, now let's update on the trade. For QuantumScape, recently, every day it's been doing slowly climbing, and I think this is quite healthy. Instead of growing like a big red or green bar, that would make me more alert or like a meme stock. But for QuantumScape, it's really looking like a steady climb, slow but steady, healthy. And every time after a run up, it would do a washing before moving up again to wash out the profit taking. So at this point, I think it's still looking healthy. It might pull back if the market does pull back, but overall, it seems like the bottom has been confirmed. So that's why I'm still holding on my shares. But yesterday, I did set an automatic order to sell part of the position at 32.2. Today it went up to 32.4, the highest. So I opened my broker and thought, so I thought I sold half of my position, but turned out it says expire. I thought I could sell it first and buy it back at the dip, but it seems like it's fate that wants me to keep it longer. Fine, then I'll keep it longer. I usually take part of the position to take profit first, and if it gives me further dip, I'll buy more. If it doesn't, I will just move on. Speaking of which, I also set automatic order to sell EH part of my position with the limit order of 43, because last night I said I think it would go up to 43 before dipping. And of course, I missed it by 40 cents today. SOS is still running up. At some point, it was looking like it could pass the resistance of 4, and then it came back down when the market was starting to dip. If the next day it can get back on, the next resistance is 4.4. Even Mesa went up a bit today, but it's not enough to confirm yet. If it can close above 9.7 this week in the next following days, I think I would consider buying it back, the position I trimmed yesterday. HOL is backtesting the support of 11.3. I think it's good dip to buy. Stop loss can be moved from 10 to 10.5 now. It looks like IQ is starting to break out too even. It's about time. And the next one to break out might be Viomi, ticker symbol VIOT. Don't forget this play for our Internet of Things. Now Tuya has broken out long time ago. It had gone from the lowest of 15 to the highest of 26, almost making all-time high already. So the next one has got to be our Viomi. Hopefully it won't take too long. Okay, now that's it for today. And if you have enjoyed this video, please give me a big, big like and write me a great comment. And I'll see you in my next video. That's it, guys. Hope you can find my videos helpful. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and give me a big like. Thank you.